Jake Hardman has asked us how to paint the armour of fire slayers from the Thungur Lodge. Now, to do this, what you want to do is start out with a base coat of lead belcher, and then we shade all over the metal using Caraberg Crimson to give it that pinkish reddish tinge. Then we'll need Ironbreaker to make some parts of a brighter silver, and then finally we'll add a highlight of Stormhost Silver. Now, for my example miniature, I'm starting from an undercoat of Corax White, but this is just because Corax White is a great undercoat for these miniatures. It's always good for a miniature where there's lots of flesh showing, but you can do this from any undercoat colour that you want to. So we need to start out with lead belcher then for our base colour, which I'm going to be applying with a medium base brush. And what you want to do is, as always, make use of your palette to get your paint ready. So add a small amount of water in there so it's nice and thin, nice and smooth, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying it to your model. Now I'm going to focus on doing this on the shield here to show you what to do, but you can apply this technique to any piece of armour on a fire slayer that you want to paint. Once you've finished applying that base coat, you're now ready to paint some Caraberg Crimson all over the metal. And you don't want to put this on too thickly, just be sure it settles nicely in the recessed detail, but on the flatter parts, you just want a hint of that red to give it that pinkish tinge. Once that shade's completely dry, you're ready to pick out all the parts that you want to be the brighter silver using Ironbreaker. And the things you're looking for here are stuff like swirls like this inside the shield, and also the trim of it as well, but you still need to avoid those recessed details to keep that red still showing, just to give a bit of definition. And finally, apply an edge highlight of Stormhost Silver to both tones of the silver, following all the sharpest edges. And here we have the completed shield, and of course you can apply this technique to any piece of the armour or even the weapons that you want to paint on your fire slayers. So Jake, I really hope that's answered your question, and remember, everyone, keep your requests coming in, and we'll see you all again very soon.